welcome to the Lindsay Show. Today we will talk to our guest, Eddie Slater. Eddie is a 15-year-old boy who is currently living in Calgary, and his story has been read by thousands. His big adventure is depicted in the book, Last Time's Cage. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and welcome Eddie Slater.
Before I ran away, my stepfather beat me constantly, usually for little things like, you know, not bringing him his coffee fast enough. I was angry at my mom for never stepping in, but mostly angry because she married Steve in the first place. I felt like I was alone at home all the time, with no one to love me or care for me.
After your father died, Eddie, how did your relationship with your mother change, like after she married Steve and all?
It was really after she married Steve that there was a big change. At first she was happy, but then not so much. When Steve first started to abuse my mom, I stepped in, and that was when he decided that I would be his new victim. My mom really changed after that. She was more distant. We never spent any time together. It was like the spark in her life was gone now.
After running away, how did your life change?
Yeah, the big difference when I ran away was that I didn't have to live in fear of Steve anymore, or of making him angry. And I also had to learn how to support myself. Another change was the way I bathed. Oof, it was pretty chilly in the river that day. I also had to be more aware of my surroundings, so I had to be more careful that I didn't accidentally meet up with somebody I knew I was missing. It was so scary to be by myself at first, but, you know, I got used to it.
So, after you ran away, was it difficult to be living on your own, or was it more of a relief?
Well, after I left, I was still scared that Steve would find me and, you know, kill me or something, but I was happy because even though I had to support myself and I could not continue my old way of life, I was able to live without being constantly afraid of that if I did something wrong, Steve would hurt me. It was a big change, but it was more of a relief for sure.
After doing break and enters for so many years, what do you think the reasons were that the spark and excitement was gone?
I know it sounds crazy, but I think that I committed crimes before just to make Steve angry. So once he was out of the equation, I didn't need to feel that I was the bad boy anymore.
So your friend Jack had a very complicated past. Do you care to explain it?
Well, when Jackson was 12, his little sister was murdered. He was supposed to be watching her that day at the zoo. Angela was her name, you see, and she was dragged off into the woods and killed when she was 8. Ever since then, for 32 years, Jack has come to the park at the zoo to watch the children to make sure they were safe so they didn't get hurt like his sister did.
Although you needed the money, do you regret going to the pawn shop and meeting Jules?
You know, it seems like it would, but I don't. It was really the event that ended my ordeal. If I hadn't gone to the pawn shop, Jules would have never followed me, and Sink would have never found me at the zoo. But, you know, Jack wouldn't have been able to fulfill his dream of helping a child. Also, Sink probably would have never left me alone if Jack hadn't threatened him with the knife. But I think that by Jack saving my life, it really helped him fill the hole that was made by the thought that it was his fault that his little sister died that day at the zoo.
If Steve hadn't left your mom in the end, what was your plan going to be?
Yeah, I don't know what I really would have done. I was just kind of flying by the seat of my pants up until then. I would have had to find a new place to live, because by the time winter came, it would have been way too cold to stay outside anymore. I would have been good for a couple months, though. And until then, I probably would have just continued my way of life by doing break and enters just to get by.
How influential was Jackson on your life?
Jackson was very influential on my life. Without him, I would be dead. He saved me from stinking Jules, for sure. Without Jack, I wouldn't have made it through the cold nights either at the zoo. I probably would have ended up going back to live with Steve or something, or going to a shelter, but, you know, Jack was not only my savior, but he was also my friend. I am happy that I met Jack, because I probably wouldn't be here without him.
Looking back on your whole experience, are you glad you ran away in the end?
I know it sounds weird, but I'm happy I ran away. I got away from Steve, I made a new friend, which is Jack, and now when people ask me, like Miss Clara Campbell, that if I've ever had an adventure in my life, I can say yes. I think that by running away, I really saved my life, because in the time that I was gone, Steve could have easily killed me if I had stayed home. Even though it was close with Stink that time at the zoo, I think that I made the right choice. I also think that by running away, I helped Jack get over the feeling that he let his sister's death happen. I think he felt that he had fulfilled his lifelong dream because he saved me from being killed by Stink. Me running away affected many people for the good, for sure.
So, Eddie, I hear that you have a big movie coming out.
Yeah, my new movie's coming out this year. It was fun to film. I hope that people enjoy it as much as I do. I think it really shows a lot about, you know, child abuse and what one person can, how one person can make such a difference in a person's life, like Jack did on mine.
Let's take a look at your trailer.
Falling 1,000 feet per second, you still take me by surprise. I just know we can't be over. I can see it in your eyes. Making every kind of silence takes a lot to realize. It's worse to finish than to start all over and never let it lie. And as long as I can feel you holding on, I won't fall. Even if you said I was wrong, I'm not perfect, but I keep trying, 'cause that's what I said I would do from the start. I'm not alive if I'm lonely, so please don't leave. Was it something takes a lot to realize? It's worse to finish than to start all over and never let it lie. And as long as I can feel you holding on, I won't fall. Even if you said I was wrong, I know that I'm not perfect, but I keep trying, 'cause that's what
today.
Yeah, thanks. It was great to be here. Thank you very much, Lindsay.
I thought unicorn was so extinct, but unicorn live in Banff.